There are many situations in war that are gray. And that's a real challenge when it comes to autonomous weapons. How would a robot know the difference between what's legal and what's right? How would it know to tell the difference? Is it acceptable for a machine to make life and death decisions in war? And if we answer it, that might help us give us a guide for how we use this technology going forward in ways that might make warfare more humane, but also don't lose our humanity in the process. When people worry about autonomous weapons, one of the fears would be robots running amok and killing civilians. The sort of things you see in Terminator movies. No one's building that. That's the good news. We're talking about weapons that, once launched and programmed and built by a human, would then make a decision on their own about which specific targets to attack. One of the arguments for autonomous weapons is that just like someday self-driving cars could reduce accidents on roads, perhaps machines could do the same in war. And autonomous weapons could avoid civilian casualties, making war more precise and more humane. In World War II, nations bombed entire cities and killed hundreds of thousands of civilians. One of the unfortunate realities of the technology of the time was bombing was not very precise. Today, advanced militaries can actually place a bomb precisely where they want to. I was involved in wrestling with a lot of these challenges when I worked in the Pentagon as a policy analyst in the Office of the Secretary of Defense. We worked on various emerging technologies, including autonomy and robotics. There are some ways that we have experience using autonomy. Things like homing munitions or automated defensive systems that the military has already used for decades. Swarms are the next step in military robotics, where the human is no longer manually controlling robots or directing them where to go, but instead telling the swarm what to do, ordering the swarm to, say, patrol an area or conduct reconnaissance. And people are experimenting with what this might look like and how it would dramatically change military tactics in warfighting. How do you fight with a swarm? What are the commands to give a swarm? How do swarms fight each other? What are the best tactics for swarm warfare? The reality is that we can test autonomous systems all that we want in training environments and simulations, and we can never perfectly simulate the chaos of war. What, if anything, requires uniquely human judgment in war, and why? Are there some things that we don't want machines to do at all? And I think that's a really important question to ask. I saw things firsthand in war that I don't think machines could deal with. Situations that I faced that I think are too complex, that require human judgment and moral understanding. There was an incident early in the war in Afghanistan where I was part of an Army Ranger sniper team. And on one mission, we infiltrated at night. And when sun came up, we were pretty exposed. Now, what we expected to happen was that some fighters would come to attack us, and we were ready for that. What we didn't expect was they sent a little girl to scout at our position. She walked a long, slow circle around us and watched us for a while. And we heard the chirping of what we later realized was a radio that she was carrying with her, reporting back information about us. Eventually she left, and not long after some Taliban fighters did come. And we took care of that. But later we were talking about what we would do in a similar situation like that. If we came across someone and we didn't know if they were a civilian and they were scouting for the enemy, what would we do? Something that never came up in conversation was the idea of shooting this little girl. The laws of war don't set an age for combatants. Your status as a combatant is based on your behavior. And by scouting for the enemy, she was directly participating in hostilities. If you programmed a robot to comply perfectly with the laws of war, it would have killed this little girl. And I think that's wrong. I think that would have been morally wrong. If we had a war and no one felt bad about the fact that we were killing other human beings, what would that say about us? What would it say about us if no one slept uneasy at night afterwards? These moments of humanity seem important. They seem like something that we wouldn't want to give up. It's an opportunity for humans to exercise empathy and recognize the humanity of the other side. War presents lots of complex moral challenges that people face. And I don't really think that any machines that we see today or in the foreseeable future will be able to deal with those challenges. Not because the machines cannot make those decisions, but because they shouldn't. And I think there's a really important role for human judgment in making these moral decisions in war. And as we move forward with the technology, we don't want to give that up. We want to keep humans in charge of making these decisions.
Thanks for watching this episode of Uprising. Please like and subscribe. It really helps us grow our channel and tell more stories about people who are thinking differently and changing the world. Check out Paul Scharre's book, Army of None.